Hi, I'm Jaclyn Aremka, P4 pharmacy student from Drake University, here on my non-patient care academic rotation with Dr. Tony Guerra. And today we're going to be going over antibiotics, so kind of breaking down all the different antibiotics into their different mechanisms of action, and then at the end we'll be focusing on time versus concentration dependent and static versus cytal as well. So really the first category that I broke everything down to is going to be inhibiting cell wall synthesis. And these can be broken down into our beta-lactams, our glycopeptides, and our lipoglycopeptides. So first, starting off with our beta-lactams, we have three different types of penicillins. We have just our regular penicillins, and how I remember these is G and IV, it kind of rhymes, G-I-V, and then you have penicillin VK, which sounds very, it just sounds harsh, so I think oral because of the sound that it makes. And then we have our amino penicillins, which goes into amoxicillin or moxetag and ampicillin. And because they're amino penicillins, they both start with that A, is how I remember that as well. Then we have our penicillinase resistant penicillins, so our methicillin, napsilin, and oxicillin. And how I remember these three is methicillin is, we think of methicillin when we're thinking of methicillin sensitive staph aureus. So that's a specific type of bacteria that we're treating. So then we have our napsilin and our oxicillin. So these kind of go together in the sense that one of them will be, one's the way that we classify it, one's one that we use to actually see if the antibiotic is, or excuse me, if the bacteria is resistant, and then the third one is the one that we actually use to treat. So that's how those three kind of go together. So those are our three different penicillins that we have. Then we move into our cephalosporins, and there's five different generations of our cephalosporins. So I kind of broke these down, and I like to draw out this little picture on the side too. It can be thought of as like plus, minus, plus. So, and that's the spectrum of the gram coverage that these antibiotics have. So the first generation are going to have a lot of gram-positive coverage, and the fifth generation are going to have a lot of gram-positive coverage as well. And then there's going to be a varying coverage in the middle, but the highest peak of gram-negative coverage is going to be generation four with our cefepime. So the way that I like to remember these, so our first generation, we have cephalexin and cefazolin. And I like to remember the N at the ending. So the way that these are going to differ are going to be in the administration. So cephalexin is going to be an oral medication, and then cefazolin is going to be an IV medication. So the way that it goes in is going to differ between those two. Then we have our second generation, which is cefprazil and cefaclor. And then our third generation, we have ceftonir, ceftazidime, and ceftaxime and ceftazidime. Yep, are our three. And then there's also another one, ceftriaxone, which I just didn't include because of spacing issues on the board here. Then our fourth generation, the main one that we're going to focus on is going to be cefepime. And then the last one is ceftaroline. Then we move down into our carbapenems here, and mainly these are going to be used for our ESBL, or extended spectrum beta-lactamase producers. So these are going to have really broad spectrum coverage antibiotics. So these aren't going to typically be used that often unless we're really concerned about resistance issues. And the way that I like to remember these are, I just realized that it spells out DIME, the first initials of all the medications. So we have, these are going to be our penems. So dorapenem, imipenem, meropenem, and ertapenem. And then our two vowels are the ones that I really underlined in terms of differences between the two. So our imipenem, we worry about seizure side effects with this specific medication. And then ertapenem is going to differ between the D, I, and M in terms of its coverage. This is going to be a little bit less specific because it doesn't cover a specific specific bacteria called Pseudomonas. So that's how ertapenem is a little bit different. And then our last beta-lactam is going to be our monobactam, and that's going to be estrianam. And the main difference with this medication is all of these medications really can cause some hypersensitivity reactions. And as Trianam isn't going to have any cross-reactivity with any of the above medications. So this can be used for patients that you're really concerned about having some of that cross-reactivity. Okay, then we move into our glycopeptide, specifically vancomycin. And this, I like to think of red man syndrome as kind of a side effect of this medication. So we like to think of the flushing, and it's also severely nephrotoxic. So we worry about patients that have declined kidney function as well. And then the last cell wall synthesis medication that we'll focus on is going to be the lipoglycopeptides. And these are going to be our avancins. So again, this spells out DOT is the way that I like to remember it. So we have delbavancin, eridavancin, and telavancin. And again, we're going to worry about the nephrotoxicity with these medications as well.